Today I'll test eGPU from AliExpress, turn my office laptop into a gaming with RTX 4090, show the perfect scenario for using eGPU, and some benchmarks. But first, let me quickly show you what came in the package. The standard kit from this seller comes with a half meter Thunderbolt cable, but I choose the option with 2 meter cable, and in the end, I received both of them. Overall, the packaging is surprising. We got two plates for power supplies of different form factors, SFX and ITX, and even a screwdriver. The power supply is not included, so we'll use a cheap one from Gigabyte for 650 watts. The connection is quite simple. First we attach the plate, then the power supply, and connect it. As a GPU, I will use my 4090 from home computer for this experiment. I know that it's overkill, but I don't have another one. So, we insert our GPU, screw it in place, and connect the cables from the power supply. On the back, we have three ports. Thunderbolt with power delivery at 60 watts, which allows you to connect the laptop and charge it at the same time. Simple Thunderbolt and USB 3.0. Power delivery sounds good to me, so we'll use it. There is also an indicator. Blue means that it's connected to the power source, and green means that it's working and connected to the laptop. Speaking of the laptop, it's a typical office ultrabook that I've been working on for just over a year. ThinkPad T14S Gen 1 with energy efficient i5 that has 4 cores, 8 threads and 16 gigs of DDR4 memory. Obviously, it's not designed for games and CPU here will be a bottleneck, especially with the 4090. But it makes it even more interesting for me. It has Thunderbolt 3, so why not? It's time to connect our eGPU to the laptop. And here everything is as simple as possible. We connect the cable, a new device is detected, install drivers for video card, and that's it, ready to use. But here's a few nuances. Your laptop must have Thunderbolt 3, 4 or USB 4 port. You will not get full performance of a high-end GPU because of a transfer speed limit. This connection supports only 4 PCIe lines compared to 16 on a standard motherboard, so it makes almost no sense to connect video cards higher than a 3080 level. But remember that if you plug 3080 into a desktop, you will get much more out of it. If you use a laptop monitor for gaming, you will lose some performance, as the signal will go from the laptop to the GPU and back. It's like a waste of resources. But if you connect to an external monitor, the image from the GPU will go directly to the monitor. I want to mention that the USB 3 port allows me to connect the USB hub. In my case, it's a monitor where all my peripherals such as mouse, keyboard, webcam are plugged into. Also, I can extend the memory by connecting an external SSD directly to the eGPU. This way, I don't need to store all my games in the laptop's memory since they are useless without the graphics card. And with just one cable, I can connect everything I need and my Steam library updates instantly. And we are ready to go! So I can game on an office laptop? That's incredible! Until you realize that it's a result of 4090. Of course, in my case there was an issue with CPU throttling, and sometimes you can see CPU frequency at 2.2 GHz, so the laptop could cool down. Also, some games were just unplayable because of stutters. So maybe idea of thin ultrabook may be unrealistic due to a weak cooling system. But if your laptop doesn't have these problems, congratulations! You have a green light for using an external GPU. I really like the idea of a portable computer. But at the same time, I don't like gaming laptops. They're heavy, noisy, expensive, and in the most cases, look like a toy for a teenager. But this is a completely different story. In theory, I can use a lightweight laptop for my needs, and at any moment connect it to eGPU and turn it into a gaming computer. Just make sure that CPU has a good cooling system. Just imagine, by connecting a single cable, I get charging, powerful GPU, one or more monitors, external SSD, keyboard and mouse, webcam, headphones and speakers. I can even connect a VR headset to it. I think you got my point. And if you don't like how it looks and want to hide GPU and cables, you can cover it with a case. I think I can recommend this seller since he was nice to me when I faced some problems. He accidentally disconnected CPU power cable and thought the problem was in the device. So if you want to boost your laptop, it's a good option. Wanna know what else could be a good option? Subscribe!